If I can summarize everything I learned in the last 30 years about terrorism, it would be that sentence. I refer to that as the equation of terrorism. What is the equation of terrorism? The equation of terrorism has two factors. Motivation plus or multiple the operational capability. Which means when you have a group of people that has both, motivation to attack, to conduct terrorist attacks, and they have the operational capability that allows them to materialize the motivation, you are going to suffer from terrorist attacks. By the way, from the equation of terrorism, we can learn what is the equation of counterterrorism. The same equation. In counterterrorism, you need either to lower down the motivation that leads to terrorism or lower down the operational capability that leads to terrorism. On the face of it, it's enough to deal with one factor. Because if you would have a group of people that has high motivation, but they cannot materialize the motivation, a terrorist attack would not be conducted, and vice versa. If they have high level of operational capability and no motivation, again, you are not going to suffer from terrorist attacks. That's the good news. The bad news is that dealing with one factor is not a solution for terrorism. Once you are trying to lower down the operational capability of the terrorist, how do you do that? Only one way. You attack them. You use proactive activity, you use offensive activity, targeted killings, arrests, and so on and so forth. Once you do it, and as much as you do it successfully, what happens as an outcome of that? You raise their motivation to retaliate. That's the boomerang effect in counterterrorism. So trying to stress down, to limit both motivation and operational capability at the same time, this is maybe the biggest challenge of every counterterrorist in the world. Having that in mind, I would like to analyze the American approach to counterterrorism in general. President Bush, in his counterterrorism policy, he was focusing after 9/11 in lowering down the operational capability of the terrorists. The outcome was the war in Afghanistan, the war in Iraq, and so on and so forth. The effort was to cut the capabilities of Al-Qaeda, the global jihadists, and the terrorists worldwide. I would say that he didn't pay enough attention, and I'm saying that not in a retro perspective point of view. I have concrete letters that I wrote to his administration at that period of time. He didn't pay enough attention to the need, simultaneously, to deal with counter-motivation. It started at the end of his term, but it was too late. President Obama came with the opposite policy. President Obama came with a clear understanding that there is a need to deal with the motivations, causes, root causes, and so on and so forth. Maybe we'll talk about the term root causes later on. So we need to deal with the motivations, but he didn't really get it, in my view, that there is at least the same level of need to deal with the operational capability of the terrorists. And I do believe that President Obama and his administration got it all wrong. Turkey represents the other way of being a Muslim. They represent the ability to be a genuine Muslim and be open to modernity and to be open to the Western society. And Turkey is turning into an important member of the Iranian axis in the Middle East and the Arab world. So we see that in the zero-sum game in the last 10 years, the pragmatic axis is losing, i.e., United States is losing. And when people are asking me what is the subject matter of your next book, I'm telling them, let me tell you what is the subject matter of Condoleezza Rice's next book. And this was to introduce democracy to the Muslim world. Democracy will win. Democracy will solve the problems. This is the miracle solution. We will just introduce that to the Muslim world and everything will be fine. My book is all about how terrorists and fundamentalists are misusing democracy and democracy apparatuses in order to promote their atrocities, their goals, and so on and so forth. She was talking about the election in the Palestinian arena. And she was saying, you know, I am not concerned even if fundamentalists are winning the elections. I quote. And you know why? Because it's only temporarily. After a while, after 4 years, 8 years, the people will understand that they got it all wrong and they will vote them out. She didn't understand that when fundamentalists are winning democratic election, it's a one man, one vote, one tie. No way to get rid of them. What the Americans didn't understand, and I'm saying Americans, by the way, because it's a bipartisan problem. It's not the Republicans, or not just the Republicans, or the Democrats. This is an American naivete. It's a cultural thing.